Operation Shuja is, according to General Olum, not only a military incursion, but a strategic end state to the means and livelihoods to the people of Eastern Congo and Uganda, where armed groups have wreaked havoc for years.
He is on top of this mission. He knows it better than most of us. And he has all the reasons as to why he thinks UPDF should stick into this country. The President of Congo, President Tshisekedi, he knows why the UPDF is very important here to undertake a joint operation with the Congolese military. They all understand that. And they don't only look at this operation as a military incursion. Both President Museveni and President Tshisekedi look at this as a strategic end state to the means and livelihood of the people of Congo, especially the Eastern Congo, and the people of Uganda to the west of Uganda.
Although major milestones have been achieved in the last 2 years of Operation Shuja, General Olum says that the ADF terrorists fight a war that is not conventional and has no clearly demarcated front line. General Olum explains that the Allied Democratic Forces have since split into smaller groups whose bases are currently not easy to detect.
I think that we have a specific timeline to which we can tag the completion of this mission is a bit difficult. That this ADF we are talking about today is a force of terrorists who have spent over 20 years in the jungles of Congo. Eliminating them is not just like that.
General Olum is confident that if the ADF terrorists launched an offensive attack against Uganda, they would be dealt with accordingly.
From Beni, Oicha, Eringeti, Ndimo up to Komanda. Then from Komanda to Mombasa, Mombasa back through Oicha to Beni. That is the triangle we are calling Sector 4. We shall be extremely deep into all those areas, trying to search for this guy, for we know they are there.
Over the last 2 years of the operation, General Olum says that a lot of lessons have been learned.
For me, lessons learned, that don't leave the ADF to disturb you in Uganda. Close your borders and you think they will not cross, they'll continue crossing. Now we have come here, Uganda is safe and the Congolese are safe. That's a huge lesson. I have learned that the jungle operation is possible.
Currently, the UPDF is also engaged in some civil-military activities with the Congolese community, according to General Olum.
Patching up the roads, that's a civil-military cooperation. We do that for the population. The other second civil-military cooperation that we do, with the CIMIC that we do with the population, is that we allow civilians to come and take treatment from our medical stations, in the camp here.
ADF began activities in Uganda but was forced into the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo, where it is best. It carries out deadly attacks in villages near the borders and is accused of killing thousands of people in both countries since pledging allegiance to IS in 2019. The joint ground and air operation by Uganda and Congo was set up in 2021, and since then, at least 550 militias have been killed. Story compiled by Rogers Sunday for the news.